Howdy, howdy, folks. It is 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and I'm excited to be with you. I am getting my stuff here ready, and we've got 69 people with us right now, and that is freaking awesome. And I want to tell you what we're going to cover first, but I've got some stuff to go over. But I want to tell you, when you're in the chat room and you can live chat with people, be nice, though. Don't make any personal attacks. You can agree, disagree, and agree all you want, but I don't like the, you know, bullcrap personal attacks. Anyway, if you have a question, though, I'm going to answer those at the end of the show. Just type in the chat, and it will appear in a box. It should be on your screen, too, but over on my left, it puts in a little box, and it says, this person has a question, and then it tells me the question that you typed in. But in order to do that, it has to have a /// and a Q, letter Q, then just type whatever question you have. So /// Q, then a space, and then your question, or comment or whatever. You got something funny to say, do the same thing and I'll try to grab it. This is a new platform to us. We've used it a little bit, but we're going to talk about naysayers tonight. You know those people, if you got my email today, you know, I don't like them. I actually had people, email me, two people, email me because I had put the lady shooting the birds, in the email, the picture, about naysayers, and those two people didn't like that. And so they defriended me, and so they no longer get my emails because they, you know, opted out. And so because that offended them in whatever way, because fingers offend people. Anyway, doesn't matter. You know, naysayers, they say, oh, you'll never make it. I want to give you a little bit of backstory about a naysayer. And I use that funny little meme about naysayers. They always, you know, they always be naying, basically. And I don't like those. I don't like those at all. But I want to give you a little bit of a backstory. I was, you know, I've always been in this entrepreneur mode and always felt like I'm going to, you know, accomplish this or that. Hey, could y'all do me a favor? In the chat room, do you mind typing yes if you can hear me? I want to make sure everything's working. You know, we did that live event. Okay, we got yeses. Okay, so I had a satellite company. You know, we called it the Tennessee Flower because there was more of those than there were flowers in Tennessee. These big, huge monstrosity of satellite dishes. And so we had those, you know, I had a little company that would go and put those in. And you know, that slowly went away when in the early 90s when they came out with those little dishes, you know, Dish Network and DirecTV and PrimeStar, if you've been around that long. And so, you know, you constantly had to evolve and change. Well, we had a bad run of luck. This was my first real bad run of luck. And broke and married and what do you do? And so we decided, my wife loves antiques. She loves thrift stores and all that stuff. So we decide we're going to open up a thrift store, kind of, it's called Hillbilly Hand-Me-Downs. We're pretty much hillbillies. Well, we are hillbillies. And we said, okay, we're going to do this Hillbilly Hand-Me-Downs. It's just used furniture. We're going to go out and find used furniture and then resell it, you know, repurpose it. We really didn't do anything to it. We just resold it. Some people give us furniture and then you'd sell it. You know, oh, this couch we got for free, it's $10. Take it today. And back then we had a car, we had a Kia. And so we couldn't even deliver. And then I got a hitch put on the Kia, and it was the Kia Rio Cinco. Okay. And which meant it had five doors, which was really four doors and a hatchback. Little bitty car. I mean, there wasn't enough room in there to change your mind, much less anything else. So I put a hitch on that and pulled around my father-in-law's lawnmower trailer to do deliveries. And that was how we got started. Well, in a very short time, you know, that turned into a multi-million dollar business. If y'all have read my book or, you know, been around me very long, you know, it turned into a multi-million dollar company, you know, private plane and the works. But it, in the beginning, when we told people, hey, we're excited. My wife and I are not going to be doing this anymore. No more satellites, no more this. She had started cleaning cabins, you know, here in the mountains. She started cleaning cabins and she goes, and we had the people that going, what? There's like 1,700 furniture stores and used stuff. Why would you try to open one? And I ignored that. I ignored it. And I kept going. Now, I can't tell you it didn't bother me, but I still ignored it. I had to ignore it. Otherwise, you lose track of your path. So I ignored that. Ended up being a multi-million dollar company, which I lost. I ran that sucker right into the ground in years. You know, it took me several, you know, maybe almost 10 years, but I ran that sucker into the ground. Then comes hot dogs. You know, if you've been around me, like I said, you know the story. And I'm going to give the short version for those that are new here. We lost everything. We lost the furniture business. We, you know, moved five kids into a two-bedroom trailer, single-wide trailer, two-bedroom with five kids, seven people in a two-bedroom trailer. Didn't know where our next meal was coming from kind of thing. And if we hadn't had family around us, we probably would have been up the creek. And so family helped and, you know, bring over groceries and, you know, and so everything worked out, but I needed money. So the first thing that the first real thing that I found that could maybe provide us money is I had read a story about these vendors that this vendor family lost everything in 2007, I believe this was, and they had lost everything and they were going to start a hot dog cart, and they did, and they were successful with it. And I was like, well, I could do that. I hadn't even ever seen a hot dog cart except in movies. You know, East Tennessee isn't like a mecca for hot dog carts. So, you know, you see them in New York streets and Florida. They're all over Florida. And so you go, where's, I'm going to do it. Oh my gosh, they came out of the woodworks. The naysayers, the negative people. You know, and I've got several things to say about that. You know, it's the, you know, do it because they said you couldn't do it. Okay. And now, mind you, I didn't come up with all these quotes and things, but it definitely tells you my sentiment as far as it definitely adheres to how I feel. Those that say you can't do it. We have a vendor listening tonight, I believe. Oh, doggies, if you don't follow him, you ought to be slapped. On Twitter and Facebook and wherever else you can follow him. Just be like a social media whore and follow him. And but started with nothing, basically. A home-built cart now has a restaurant, okay? I am positive he had the naysayers. Just as I did and just as you did. Every week I get calls, almost daily, somebody calls me and says something, or they leave a message and they go, Ben, really this, you know, I wanted to do this, but my wife, she just doesn't, or it's the wife calling me saying the husband doesn't, or the father-in-law doesn't, or the brother doesn't, or whoever. And it's all just noise. It's all just noise. It's noise that you have to put out. You have to just extinguish that noise and focus on your goals. It's what it comes down to, basically. But I wanted to give you some of these just so that you understand. Before I move on, though, I gotta do a couple shout-outs. Congrats to Mark. Mark's first day, and we posted this picture on our Facebook page. It's facebook.com/ Ben's Carts. One word, Ben's Carts. And somebody may want to share that in the chat area, but either way, Mark, his first day sold out. Okay. First day ever selling hot dogs. He's on a big dog cart with a grill and he just kicks butt. Okay. He emailed me. He was so excited. He goes, I needed about 60 more hot dogs. I didn't know what to do. And, And it was exciting. He even sent a picture. You can tell he's worn out, and he goes, oh my gosh, this was so fun, but it was, oh my gosh, it was a lot of work. And it is. This isn't like a get rich quick scheme. It's real money. You can make great money, but it's still work. Well, Michael Wood, made a great statement, on the Facebookers, that I loved. And if you haven't gone over there, look at his post that he posted. Fantastic guy. Been vending for 5-6 years now, and you may want to read that. Inspirational. David of Texas, Outlaw Grill. Texas Outlaw Grill. Brilliant menu. One of the best menu pictures I've ever seen. There's about 5 menu pictures in my years that I've seen that looked just dynamite. Kind of like Corey Lawrence with O'Doggies. He posts up these pictures that look like a professional photographer took them of his menu. He'll make something and then take a picture of it, and you go, what? Would y'all Photoshop that? Well, this menu is so brilliantly done with these big foot-long hot dogs. It is just beautiful. So go check that out. But what I want to say about naysayers, prove them wrong, okay? Prove them wrong. Don't do it because they said you couldn't do it, or do it because they said you couldn't do it. If that's your motivation, if that helps you go, you know, a lot of people are, they do stuff. It's like a parent, you know, I have 10 kids, and you'd say, some of the kids, you could say, hey, don't eat that, and they're going to eat it anyway. Don't put that in your mouth. They're going to do it anyway. They do the opposite of whatever you tell them to do. So I got smart with that, and I was like, don't eat that ice cream. Don't eat that second bowl of cereal. And, you know, I tried my little reverse psychology tricks with them. But bottom line is, if that helps you to go, okay, because you said don't do it, I'm going to do it. Don't get trapped thinking small, because small is contagious. Okay, the poor me is contagious, and negativeness, period. I don't even know if that's a word. It is in Tennessee. I just claimed it. It's contagious, and don't let that happen. Don't let people stand between you and your goals. Yeah, you can take that noise, I call it white noise, and move on. I get it now. I get people that blah, blah, blah. I get other manufacturers that blah, blah, blah. And I get other, I get crap. But it doesn't matter. They're just people. Everybody's got their opinions. They're like buttholes. Everybody's got one. And sometimes I've been, you know, I'm wrong sometimes. But when you have a goal, when you set your mind on something, you need to achieve that something. You need to go for that something, regardless of the crap. If you do your due diligence. Now, I don't want you to go, okay, well, I'm 72 years old, and I am going to be an astronaut. Because that crap that we heard from our parents that you can do and be anything you want to be is bull crap. Because you can't. There is no you can be anything. Not in the literal sense of the word anything. You can't be a unicorn. Everybody can't be astronauts. I don't care how hard they try or how good they are. I would love to be an astrophysicist. Because one of the clout that would give one. But it doesn't mean it's going to happen, and it's not going to happen. I don't have enough IQ points to create a rabbit cage. I'm definitely not going to be a astrophysicist, but I admire them. So surround yourself with positive people. And I'm going to talk about that in a little bit because it's important. But surround yourself with positive people all the time. And every now and then, negativity is going to slip in. Negative people, negative words, even your own self, you're going to have negative thoughts, negative feelings. And just treat it like you would any other negative thing and get rid of it. There's things we can change in life, and there's things we can't. Okay, there's things where we can reduce risk and things we can't. I have, as many of you know, 7 daughters, and one of my girls may come to me and say, Dad, I'm worried that so-and-so is going to break up with me, or he's going to cheat on me. And I have this same little speech. In fact, I should have just numbered them and say, okay, that's number 217. Remember that number 217 speech. Remember that. That's your moral uplift. Then I wouldn't have to repeat it over and over. But the point is I gave this. I said, number 217 is there's things that you can't change. There's things you can't control is a better word. Can you right now control the fact that you have risk if you go out tomorrow out in the yard, you could be on a clear day struck by lightning? Well, if you're listening and you're welcome to post up, I'm watching the chat room too. You could be hit by lightning. But how many of you, and we have 72 listening right now, how many of you really worry tomorrow that you're going to be struck by lightning? It's because you can't control it and you know you can't. And so you do not worry about it. It does not change how you operate in your day. You don't walk around with lightning rods and dragging chains on the ground just in case. Well, that's how this is there's things you can control and things you can't control. The things that you can, focus on those. Don't focus on the crap and the BS that you can't. I can't control if on the way to get the groceries with my wife that a drunk driver doesn't pull out and hit me. I cannot control that. So guess what I choose not to do? I don't worry about it. I don't worry at all about it because I can't control it. The things I can control, though, I worry about. Like in this situation, you decide, and this would apply to any job, but I have a bias, obviously, to street food vending. And I decide I'm going to be a street food vendor. And yes, there's naysayers. There's things I can control in that. Does it mean that I'm going to make it? Does it mean that I'm not going to have obstacles? Well, the obstacles I can't control. There's some obstacles I can control by doing due diligence, by doing my homework. But there's some I can't. I can't control the guy that rear-ends me at the red light while my hot dog cart's connected to the back. I can't control those things, so I don't worry about those things. So I worry about what I can control. Now, we already talked about surrounding yourself with positive people. That is a big deal, okay? When you find yourself, I know there's a blue million hot dog groups and stuff, and I hear stuff from them constantly. People send me screenshots, look what this person said. And I go, leave. Just leave. Don't announce that you're leaving. Just leave. Separate yourself from negative crap. Okay? It's not like it's a disease, like it's going to make you sick and die, but it will make your livelihood and the odds of your success sick and die. So why not just avoid those things? Avoid those things you can control. You know, change those and not worry about the rest. Now, usually the people that are after you, the people that are the most negative about your new venture or your idea, or maybe you decide like the guy that we talked about the other night, he said, I am going to start vending in the morning. I don't want to vend in the day. I'm just going to vend in the morning's coffee. He got so much BS over that, and he ignored it. He focused and he said, no, I'm going to do this. I've tested it. It's working. I don't have to work the lunch crowd. I can work a breakfast crowd. I can create a whole new niche at 5th and Main. So the people, though, that give him the most crap, that give you the most crap, usually are too weak to follow their own dreams. Too freaking weak. And so misery, you've heard this, loves company. And that's what people do. Some people, not everybody, but some people are miserable and they want you to be equally as miserable. Some people are negative and want you to be as equally negative. Some people are pessimists to a fault. I'm an optimist to a fault. I will oftentimes, jump before looking, so to speak, in business. I'll do things because I feel good about it, but I didn't do my homework good enough. And I've learned the hard way to slow down and, Take a skeptical view, use reason and logic, and then attack it. And the odds of success go dramatically up, you know, exponentially higher. So the person that says it can't be done should not interrupt those that are already doing it. Not my quote, but I love it. So the people who say it can't be done should not interrupt us, the ones that are already doing it. And that's what happens with these naysayers, these people that make you feel like they make you second guess your own self. They make you second guess at all. That isn't worth a crap. That, you know, they would rather see you. Why don't you just get a job down at, who was told this out of the vendors listening tonight? Give me a yes or something. If you were told before, as you were getting started, that this was a bad idea, you met a naysayer. David says yes. Corey says yes. Oh, doggies. So absolutely. There's definitely, Kevin says yes, that definitely an issue. Definitely an issue with it. It's just one of those things. There's nothing you can do about it other than ignore it, block it out, and move on. Focus. Do you know in the horse races, you've heard of blinders? Do you know what those are? They put on the horses in races, even today, they put these blinders on them. And they do that because horses get sidetracked. They see another horse or something, they'll slow down and look. They're like a squirrel in the road, you know, or a deer in headlights. So they put blinders on them so they only see ahead of themselves. They can't see behind them. And if a horse sees another horse ahead of itself, it will try to catch up to it. But if it sees one beside it, it's going to slow down and take a look. It's just how horses are. So they put blinders on. What you need to do is put blinders on. Mental blinders, and go, okay, I'm going to ignore the rhetoric. I'm going to ignore the naysayers. The person, let's see, here's just some tips. Protect your ideas when possible. If you think or surrounded by a bunch of negative people, protect your idea. Protect your idea. Great question, and I'm going to answer that, David. That's a fantastic question. And I've got another one here in a minute I'll answer. Anyway, protect your ideas. Don't tell them. If they don't need to know, if it's not a spouse or somebody that's, you know, crucially tied to your choices, they have no reason to know. Just avoid it. Now, I'm a loud mouth. I got to tell everybody because it makes me feel better, and I want everybody to be as excited as I am about it. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to open a bait and tackle store, and I'm going to put a worm bed in the backyard. I'm going to make millions. I want to tell everybody right now. I want to tell them about my new worm bed and how I'm going to do it with potatoes and, you know, bad sour cream. Tell them to get lost. Just tell them to get lost. Say, I don't want to hear it. If you have something, I have done the research. I'm confident in my decision. Nothing is guaranteed in life, but I'm confident in my decision. So if you have nothing positive to say, please don't say anything at all. Kind of like what your mamma used to tell you. My mamma used to say, well, with a switch in her hand, if you don't have nothing nice to say, you better not say nothing. No, I'll smack you. So also consider their position and respond appropriately. There are people in your life that love you, respect you, and want the best for you. And they may be offering alternative views. So it is crucial, if you want to maintain relationships and just not be a powerhouse and, you know, house and go, oh no, screw you, I'm doing what I want to do, don't say another word to me, blah, blah, blah. You don't want to ruin relationships, but you also want to stay focused. Well, how you can do that is find out where they're coming from. Do they understand and recognize that you've done your due diligence? That you know that street food vendors make $100,000, $200,000 a year? Do they know that? So do they know you've done the research on your city ordinances, that you've checked everything out before you've made this decision, and that you're coming to them because you're excited? Or is this one of those deals where you haven't done the research yet, which isn't bad, and going to a friend just as a sounding board? Well, if you haven't done your research, then you really can't argue if they have a negative thing to say. But many friends may take it negatively. Like if my friend comes to me and says, "Hey, I got this great idea. I'm gonna put a bouncy house on the moon, because eventually there'll be people on the moon and they're gonna get bored and they're gonna wanna. And so I've got $2 million. I'm gonna invest in getting this bouncy house on the moon." Well, if I'm his friend and I love this person, I'm definitely going to tell them how crazy that sounds and see what, and try to find out their motivation behind it. And see if I can help them make a better decision, a more educated decision. Same with some of your friends. They may go, "Oh, well, I've seen hot dog vendors fail. I remember one I saw back in 1927. He failed. He did." Well, you got to find out where they're coming from. So you, depending on who it is, you need to adjust your response and adjust how you take their information. Don't let it change your mind unless you haven't done your due diligence. Then you may want to consider all the options and look at everything, because you shouldn't go into business, because this is a real business. It isn't something you go, "I think on Saturdays I'm going to be a hot dog vendor." Not every month, but every couple months. Well, yeah, I guess you could, but I'm talking to those that want to make a living and not just a get by living, a good living. Consider what your friend is saying, or family member, if they have had experience taking risk and failing, because many of them are the more pessimistic side. They don't take risks, and so they don't try anything. "I've been working at McDonald's for 700 years and I'm going to stay at McDonald's because the job market sucks and I don't want anything different." Not that I have a problem with working at McDonald's, but if that's not your goal in life, then don't do it. But for the people that are doing it, more power to you, because I want to have somebody at the window when I pull up to McDonald's. I'd hate to know that everybody just doesn't work there anymore because they decided that McDonald's was too good for them, you know, or too bad for them, or whatever. I don't think that matters. I'm glad there's different types of people, but I want you to consider when you're talking to a friend or family member, somebody close to you who says something negative or gives you something that you perceive as negative, that you look at what they've tried, because maybe they're really not people that make risks, and they're just giving it to you. They're giving you their point of view from the risk aversion side. Their risk aversion tells them, "Oh, danger, danger, danger. Don't take chances. Don't take chances. I don't go outside if there's a cloud in the sky because it could lightning," that kind of thing. So don't get distracted at all. Refocus. And that goes back to the blinders. So don't get distracted. Even if you hear stuff, and even if you allow a conversation to take place, or even a debate, don't let that distract you from your goal. And even if the naysayers have goodwill or good intent, they're still naysayers, okay? Some of them may come out of love, but it's still naysaying. I've got some questions. I want to tell you this real quick. Let me do this real quick. I'm gonna light a cigarette, and then we're almost done. We ended up with 75 people. I'm impressed. Welcome to everybody that's on the chat room area. That's freaking awesome. I'm glad that y'all are here. Okay. One thing I missed: don't take the bait. Don't feel you must justify your position. Don't feel you have to justify it. Now, if it's a spouse, if you're starting and your husband comes to you and goes, "Whoa, now, you know, we got to talk this through." Well, there's in a marriage, if you want a happy marriage, you soundboard off of each other and you respect each other. You don't argue it. You respect each other and you go, "Okay, well, what's your negative about this?" You know, my wife and I call them lemon squeezes, where she'll go, "Okay, it's like a free zone where you get to say what you think, not negatively, not mean, not with personal animosity, but you say something and you and the other person gets to respond, and you have a conversation. Oftentimes with spouses and close family members and friends, we get real defensive quick because, oh my gosh, we don't want them being the boss of us or whatever. Welcome, Zach. I see Zach joined us. We got a lot of new people joining us. Thanks for coming on. Dog Slinger Allen, kick butt. I'm glad you are here. This is being recorded at this time, except I didn't hit the start record button, so maybe. Oh, I'm recording it separately. Check that out. I'm cool. So I will have this up for you. I'll try to get it up in the morning or tomorrow sometime. There's a start recording button in here, but they don't make it very obvious, and I'm just not used to blab yet, so next time I'll be more cautious. Now, let me finish up here, and then I'm going to answer some questions. If you have a question, put /Q, and then you type your question in the chat, and it'll go over to another box that I can look at and answer your question. Talking earlier, we talked about putting yourself with people that are positive. Surrounding yourself, you know, if you're a buzzard, you know, if you're a turkey and you surround yourself with buzzards, you end up acting like a buzzard. I say surround yourself with good people, positive people, and move on. I don't mean a bunch of people that just pay lip service. I'm talking positive people, people that have the same goals and objectives in lives. That should be your spouse too. That should be your family and friends. Your family and friends may disagree with a decision, but they have your best interest at heart. So they're not really naysayers. They're not negative people in your life. So I'm not saying leave your wife or leave your husband. But there are those that may have a spouse that is challenging. And I'm going to go into that a little bit more. But surround yourself with positive people. And not for the short-term feel-good Amway convention. Here's a free cookie. Everybody's happy. Everybody clap your hands. That kind of short-term feel good. I'm talking about people that are sounding boards in your life, people that give positive reinforcement. That's what I'm talking about. So in order to do that, we created a group, and there's still available spaces in that group. It's Vendors United. I'm going to post the link up, so you can find it. If you have any desire to, I've got a little video there. This is my, what did we call this the other day? The money grab. I'm going to post it up. Bear with me just a second. Okay, y'all should see that in the chat and over on the your other screen, maybe. I don't know how that works, but I see two screens. So that's a video. You can watch that, preferably after this is over. Just save it or something, or start it and then pause it or something. But it's a little video to tell you about Vendors United and Street Food Pro. The next thing I want to share with you, bear with me just a second. I want to share with you the, if you are new, you're listening and you've never heard of vending, basically, this is probably my most common email during the spring is, I have no money. I want to get started. How do I get started with no money? I don't have good credit. I can't get started. How do I get started? And I created a little course. It's less than $9. It's $8.99. So this is my money grab. And so you can get that little course. It's how to get started in 2 days. It's money back guarantee. If you don't like it, keep the dang thing. And it's accessible immediately. So you can get it right now. And if you don't like it, let me know. I'll refund your money. I don't want you to buy something from me that you don't like and that doesn't, that isn't for you. I don't want to take your money if it doesn't help you. I love taking your money if it helps you, and you call me up a year from now and go, listen, I started with that $9 course and now I got a fleet of carts. That'll make my day. I live on that stuff. Next one. And I promise you, I'm getting to questions. Hold on just a second. Free water. If you're already a vendor, I've been running this. This is fixing to go away as far as, it won't go away, but it'll go back to a normal price. I'm going to put this up. If you're already a vendor, And you want a way to get free bottled water that is cool. It's my new updated version of this. If you've read my book, you already know about this. This is just a lot more information and ways to use it to your benefit. How to get free bottled water and even apply that to other things. So that's one thing. I've got a person, let's see here, asking a question. Okay. What if it's your wife that's the naysayer or that has negative? The best way to overcome this obstacle, and I speak from experience, is, and not that I have some gripey, you know, wife, but I've heard from women that had husbands that were negative about it, is educating them on it. Because typically their reasoning behind not wanting to take the risk is either they feel the risk is too great or they don't know enough about it to make a good decision. So, and both of those can be overcome because you don't have to spend thousands and thousands of dollars to start. Ask Corey Lawrence. Ask a bunch of people. I mean, I've helped over 10,000 vendors. You can go to Facebook and talk to these people and go, oh, what'd you start with? Oh, I started with $300 with a piece of crap cart. We had a guy on the radio show. She sent in a picture of his cart. It was embarrassing. His cart, it was horrid. It was rusted out. The wheels fell off of it, and he put it on a lawnmower trailer and set it on it and then put a wood frame around it to make it look halfway decent. And he made it because he didn't take no. So you don't have to have thousands of dollars. So if someone is risk adverse because it's a lot of money or they anticipate a lot of money, no, it doesn't have to be. It doesn't ever have to be. You can do this without spending thousands of dollars. In fact, I teach you it's better to start with a used cart. Yeah, I sell carts. Yes, I manufacture carts. Yes, I want your business. I'd much rather have you a successful vendor and have you only as a customer when you're buying your second cart and let your first cart go to whoever else, wherever you can get the best deal, the best cart, even used. In fact, I encourage used. Get that before you start. Naysayers, though, as far as back to the wife thing, I've held the cigarette this whole time and I hadn't lit it. Naysayers, sometimes it's just a lack of knowledge. It's called ignorance, but it's not in a bad way. It's not like, oh, look at that ignorant person. No, I'm ignorant to astrophysics. There you go. So I'm ignorant to astrophysics. So somebody like Neil deGrasse Tyson may go, you're ignorant. Well, he'd be right because I am ignorant to astrophysics. He's an astrophysicist. You can't do these things. You can't ignore people like your family, and you can't just blow them off. You have to give value to what they're trying to do and try to understand it. That's why my wife and I have lemon squeezes where we sit down across from each other and we talk about it. We go, okay, this is like an argue-free zone. Not that we never argue, but this is an argue-free zone. This is an argue-free time. Tell me what your reasons are behind this decision or your reasons for wanting to make this decision. And then I can come in and then she can come in. And then we start to understand each other because we're coming from a level of respect for each other. Now, you may have, like me, my wife has endured unbelievable. She should be more risk adverse to me than she is because she's endured a lot of my trials as far as, oh, I'm going to do this and failures because I've failed. Some of it I've succeeded and succeeded big, but if it doesn't stay, what's the value other than the lessons you learn? So, but that's life, isn't it? It's life. To think anything else would be like Monday morning quarterbacking. You know, you're like, oh, you should have run to the left on that play or whatever they do. You can tell I don't watch sports. So that's what, welcome you new folks that just came in. I swear I saw a new folk. Okay. Either way, I want you to, if you have a spouse, significant other, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever it is, and they're the naysayer, they're the ones going, no, and it's bringing you down, stay focused on your goal. But also, depending on the relationship, you know, where when it's a spouse, it kind of needs to be an agreement, okay? It can't be misogynistic, well, this is how I'm doing it, damn it, and that's the way it is. No. I can tell you I've been successfully divorced twice, and I can tell you that's not the way to do it. What you do is you go at it with respect and love, the lemon squeeze. I'll tell you about the lemon squeeze stuff later. It has nothing to do with lemons or squeezing, so it's just my term for what that is, a time when you can have a talk and be honest with each other without yelling, arguing, no personal attacks, just do this. Welcome, Packers Concession, Blitzen, KC, Dog Slinger Allen. Awesome. So that's how I would do that. I hope that answered your question, David. If I didn't answer it good, give me more and I'll try to expound on it. Okay. Byron Flint has a question. Then I've got another question. Somebody just emailed me. Okay. And I'm going to pull that over here in just a second. Anyone have a copy of the Institute for Justice package on how to fight the city hall to start a cart? Yes, it's on the Institute for Justice website. And you can download it. It's also on learnhotdogs.com blog. Just type in the word justice. You'll find one that says download the package. If you still have problems, you can't find it, either one of those, call the Institute for Justice, say, mail this to me, please, because I can't find it. But it's on their site, and I have a link on the Learn Hot Dogs blog. And if I had it, like, right now in front of me, I'd get it to you, Byron. There's so much information. You go to a website, and there's so many freaking things on it, and you go, okay, I can't find this. It seems overwhelming. So don't think you're alone there in that search, but it is on there. The other thing you could do, Byron, is it is possibly Jason just dealt with a city like this that told him he couldn't vend, and he sent him the letter, and they said, oh, we didn't realize we were violating your federal constitutional rights. We'll take that back. We'll let you vend. So Jason did that recently this fall, so he has a copy of that handy. Email him. If you can't find him, go to look up Love Food Trucks or Love Hot Dogs. Either one of those, I'll find him on Facebook and his email, his message, you know, and send him a message. He'll respond. He's good like that. He helps a lot of people. I hope that helps you there. Okay. Next one. And then I think we'll be done. Unless y'all have any more questions, post them up. You have to put that /Q and then start your question in the chat for it to go over to my question box. I like this blab. I'm just not used to it yet. Okay. Oh, this is a question on an email, and that is Byron. So Byron, I'm glad you made it. I was going to read your question that you emailed me. So, freaking awesome. That was easy. And if you have no luck tonight, cause I got a ton of emails to do still. If you have no luck tonight, please, email me tomorrow and I'll see if I can hunt it down for you. I'm sure I can. It's just time. Okay. I think that's it. Did everybody enjoy that? And if you didn't, I apologize, but, I hope it helped some of you. I thank you for all the little happy, the hand things. I see that while I do this, it inspires me. It makes my little head swim. So I thank you for joining me. I posted links over in the question section and on the chat for those, the video, the course. I do want to tell you, if you're already a vendor and you need forms, I've got free forms that I just put up. And let me tell you how to do this real quick. This is be simple and easy. If you need a form on like a permission slip for a location permission slip, or you need a commissary letter, blank ones. I had our attorney do me up some just, like simple ones. When your city doesn't provide that stuff, I have it. All you have to do is, if you have a cell phone, type in the number 44222. That's the phone number to call. So it's just that long, 44222. And then in the message where you would normally say, hey, babe, I'm on my way home. Do you need me to pick up anything at the grocery store? In that section, you'd type in the word hot dog. That's it. Just hot dog. All one word, though. Even though hot dog's two words, make it one. Hot dog. And it will send you those forms. It's magic. Corey Lawrence posted that IJ stuff up for you, Byron. So it's there. Thank you, Corey. That was freaking awesome. I love freaking vendors. Y'all are awesome. And what good hearts and help each other. I love it. I'm glad to even know y'all. I thank y'all. Hope y'all have a fantastic night. Remember, you got the, you've got two things. You can go over and get those free forms I just told you about. Find out how to get the free water. You can get the video on the Vendors United group. And, also if you want to get started with little to no money really quick, that other link I posted up 2 days to vending, thanks a ton. And I will see you later. We'll try to do more of these impromptu ones, but I thought this was important, so I wanted to share it. Y'all have a good night.